العالمين صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا ثم ما بعد حديث نمبر 1469 in Riyad الصالحين كتاب الدعوات إمام النووي رحمه الله تعالى قال وعن طارق بن أشيم رضي الله عنه قال كان الرجل إذا أسلم علمه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الصلاة ثم أمره أن يدعو بهؤلاء الكلمات اللهم اغفر لي وارحمني واهدني وعافني وارزقني رواه مسلم. This hadith is interesting here. So what is the first thing the Prophet ﷺ would teach somebody when they become Muslims? In Hadith Tariq bin Ashyam, he said that whenever a man entered Islam, when someone enters the fold of Islam, قال علمه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الصلاة. The first thing the Prophet ﷺ would teach this individual is show them how to perform salah. The first thing. Because you need to worry about what? Their relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now this salah would keep them steadfast as long as they maintain it very well. And in that salah, the Prophet ﷺ, he teaches them a specific dua. Like when you teach someone dua, what do you need to look for? The most important thing for them, right? So here's the Prophet ﷺ is teaching this person, wants to become Muslims, some of the most important duas. And what is that? Seeking forgiveness. Seeking forgiveness is a priority. فَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, he would ask this person to make this dua with these words. Allahumma اغْفِرْ لِي وَارْحَمْنِي وَاهْدِنِي وَعَافِنِي وَارْزُقْنِي Allahumma اغْفِرْ لِي وَارْحَمْنِي وَاهْدِنِي وَعَافِنِي وَارْزُقْنِي This dua is what usually say between the two sajdas. When you come back from the first sajda, you make this dua. Allahumma اغْفِرْ لِي وَارْحَمْنِي وَاهْدِنِي وَعَافِنِي وَارْزُقْنِي In another narration, Tariq ibn Ashyam, he said, I heard the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم speaking to a man who asked him, Ya Rasulullah, كَيْفَ أَقُولُ حِينَ أَسْأَلُ رَبِّي If I'm going to be asking my Lord, what should I say? How do I do that? Yeah, subhanAllah, even sometimes the basic between us and Allah Azza wa Jalla is missing. So he's saying, if I'm going to calling Allah Azza wa Jalla, what should I say? So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he told him to do or to say these words, قُلْ أَللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَارْحَمْنِي وَعَافِنِي وَارْزُقْنِي فَإِنَّهَا أُولَئِ تَجْمَعُ لَكَ دُنْيَاكَ وَآخِرَتَكَ Because they have everything you need in this dunya and in the akhirah. What are these words? Let's explain them quickly. اللهم اغفر لي. اغفر لي comes from غفران. What is غفران? We say غفران means to forgive. That's what it means in English, right? But remember, the Arabic language is an animated language. It's a language, it's a visual language. If you can't visualize the word, you don't understand it very well. So al-maghfira in the Arabic language means concealment. Al-maghfira means concealment. That's why al-maghfar is that helmet that people wear when they go to the war. When the Prophet ﷺ, during the Battle of Uhud, he was hurt. The chains from al-maghfar entered his cheeks ﷺ, and broke his teeth. So that's called al-mighfar because it actually conceals the head and protects it. So the purpose of al-maghfirah over here that you seek from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is what? To conceal your sins for the purpose of what? To protect you from them. That's why we say Allahumma ghfirli. Ya Allah, conceal these sins, cover them and protect him from them. But here's the thing, al-maghfirah is a lesser daraja than al-afu. We're going to talk about afu later. We mentioned that in the previous khutbah, if you guys remember, there's the 3 degrees of forgiveness. There's al-maghfira, wal-afu, wal-safh. Al-maghfira is when you forgive somebody, meaning there is no consequence of punishment. You're not going to pursue punishment. But you might still hold grudge against them. Al-afu is when you don't pursue punishment and you remove all grudge from your heart. Afawtu ank. Nothing. And then a safh. That's when you forgive the person, clean your heart, and pretend and act like it never even happened. That's the highest level of forgiveness. Because why? Maybe you forgive the person, and you still remove the grudge from your heart, but when they meet you, they feel awkward. They feel awkward to see you because they know what they've done. So when you meet them, with safh, that means you remove everything to the extent that they don't feel awkward anymore. Now, that's the highest level of forgiveness. But here, at least, we begin with the first part. Allahumma-ghfir li, Ya Allah, forgive me, conceal these sins, erase these sins, protect me from these sins. Warhamni, you say, Ya Allah, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Why? Because, yeah, you might conceal the sins, but still, you might blame me for it. Maybe not punishment, but the blame. Say, Ya Allah, have mercy on me. Irhamni, if you are going to hold me accountable for anything, have mercy on me, Ya Rabbi Alameen. Wa-hdini. So, اغفرلي, forgive me, and have mercy on me, that's probably in the Akhirah. Because when I meet you, I want these sins to be forgiven, and you have mercy on me. In the dunya, Ya Allah, guide me. And we talked about guidance yesterday, the importance of guidance. Because these are the marks that you need on the way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Without them, you get lost. So I need guidance. Wa'afini. Afini. Al-mu'afa over here means, Ya Allah, give me protection and always protect me from the consequence of my actions. In the dunya and the akhirah. That's what the Prophet asked Allah. Ya Allah, I need protection from you, for my deen and for my dunya. وفي الدنيا والآخرة, in this world and the hereafter. I need afia, I need safety. Ya Allah, keep me safe in this world and in the hereafter. قال warzuqni, and provide for me. And provide for me. Because I know I might not be deserving of it because of what I've done. But I'm depending on your rahmah, on your mercy, on your guidance and your safety. And you provide for me even though I'm not deserving of it. That's why we make this dua. I will make it in salah between the two sajdas. So let's repeat this dua together, inshallah ta'ala, three times. Allahumma-ghfir li, warhamni, wa-hdini, wa-afini, warzuqni. Allahumma-ghfir li, warhamni, wa-hdini, wa-afini, warzuqni. اللهم اغفر لي وارحمني واهدني وعافني وارزقني. The dua from yesterday and the day before that. اللهم إني أسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم آمين. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم.